Good morning to everyone. My name is Akanksha and my partner's name is Seema, and she's my mom also. We are a mother-daughter duo who run Art Canvas Design Studio for the past 8.5 years now, and we teach a lot of sessions online almost every day, and we take a lot of sessions offline at our studio here in Baroda, Gujarat, which is where we are from. We have our own studio here. And every Friday at 11 a.m. we do a free Facebook Live workshop for simple compositions of few of our many thing topics or techniques that we teach. Today's topic is going to be knife painting. Excuse me. We are going to do this very pretty knife painting today, and we will start in about a minute. Good morning to everybody who has just joined. Hope everybody is ready for today's session, and we can go ahead and start. It's time.
So today we are going to do a palette knife painting, and there are many types of palette knife painting. Some where the entire picture is done with the knife, and some where we want the center topic to pop out and we don't want the background to be too loud. So in those paintings we do the background with brush. So this is one that type of a painting where we want the flower to show and the leaves, and we don't want the background to be very loud. So we are going to do the background with a brush, and we will do the entire flower and the leaves with the help of the palette knife. Now I'm going to use this palette knife, which is the smallest of the set of five that you get, but different brands make different sizes and of numbers and shapes, so really cannot comment on that. But if you see, this size is sufficient to do most of the pictures. So I'm going to use this, and I have a medium round brush. Any brush will do. For the background you can use a little broader brush so that you can cover it fast. And the colors that we have already mentioned in our post, mainly we will use yellows, some burnt sienna, that is a brown tone, any brown which you have, some orange and white and green. So we are going to start with the flower, and on so please use the flat side of your palette because it's easier to pick the paint with the help of the knife when the surface is flat. Also keep a tissue or a piece of rag or a cloth handy, because you might want to just keep cleaning your knife when you're changing shades. So that is the basic what we require. Now we are going to start from the center, and I'm taking some orange on my palette. Then I'm taking some burnt sienna. And I'm taking some, just a tinge of burnt umber. We don't require too much of a dark tone. So I'm just taking a little bit of burnt umber on my palette. So I've taken basically three shades. I have taken an orange, I have taken burnt sienna, and I have taken burnt umber. I am going to start from the center of the flower, and so I'm going to start from this side. So I'm taking some burnt sienna. Okay, now wherever there is no place to move your knife, there you just use the tip of the knife. I've taken paint on the tip of the knife. I'll just show you how to pick it up. You just do that. You don't make a mixture on your palette. Just pick it up on the tip of the knife. And I'm going to start using it over here. Do not flatten out your strokes. So I'm using burnt sienna, and orange right now. Good morning to everyone who has just joined us. We are doing this lovely knife painting picture. Working around the center of the flower here, those are yellow, so not going much over there. Going around these small pollens which are there in the center of the flower. I cannot zoom in a little more. I'm sorry about that because we've just set up our cameras. A little orange on this side of the flower. So just using a lot of orange here. More shadowy this side. Also a little tip, whenever you do knife painting, you must move the knife in the direction of how the picture is visible. In the sense that if you are doing a neck of an animal, then you must, if it's a rounded neck, you must always take care of how the neck is is in which direction the neck is like bending. So move your knife accordingly. Yes, I am using acrylic colors. I am not mixing anything in it. They are just basic acrylic colors that we are using. Just using a tinge of burnt umber on this side, this corner there, here. Now I have just cleaned my knife completely. I am going to take a little bit of lemon yellow on my palette. I'm going to do the center of the flower now. I'm taking yellow and I'm also going to take a little bit of white. I just cleaned my knife completely. I am taking yellow on the tip of the knife and I'm going to do the center here that way. Taking a tinge of white there, not much space to move the knife, so be careful when you're doing that. Don't go into the orange and the browns that you have just taken. A tiny one there. Now I'm just going to fix all the shapes properly before we move on to other areas. That's a little broader. That's kind of on the lower side. This is from the center going that way outward. And this one is just going out there. Now I'm going to just take a little burnt sienna on the tip of the knife and just going to go into the center of this, giving it a little more shape here. Keep your knife very light. Do not press your knife, otherwise you're going to kind of, you know, disturb. Okay, now I'm going to work on the petals which are on the outside. We start working from here. Now, earlier what I was saying, the flower is kind of opening like this. So move your knife accordingly. Add a tiny bit of orange here. petals are kind of opening like that. Do not take less paint.
Thank you, Prerna. This session will be posted to our YouTube channel. It's called Art Canvas Design Studio, and to our Facebook Live as well, but the YouTube video will be clearer. So you can, if you are not working with us right now or you wish to do it later, you can go to our YouTube channel and follow the recording and do your piece later. Do share it with us. So every upcoming session is posted before the class with the image sketch and class details, material required, everything is posted to our Instagram and to our YouTube page, to our Facebook and Instagram pages both. And this live happens only on Facebook on every Friday at 11 o'clock. So next time you can keep your sketch ready and work with us through the class if you'd like. You can share your work over WhatsApp or Instagram chat or Facebook chat. We are most responsive on Instagram chat. If you have any questions, feel free to type them out in the chat comment section. And we will try to answer as many as we can. Morning to everybody who has just joined. This is a Facebook Live workshop free, which happens every Friday morning, 11 o'clock on our Facebook page.
Follow the direction of the petals.
Prerna, please ask questions that are related to the current session. We will not be answering any cross workshop questions in this session. This is a knife painting class and you can ask questions that are related to today's class. The canvas size is 8 inches by 10 inches. You can use anything similar or bigger if you like. The canvas that we are using is 8 inch by 10 inch.
Now going to put some strokes with orange and burnt sienna, taking it on the edge of my knife.
Rashmi Rekha, I have already answered this question just now. Hello Sony, good morning.
So first I'm putting all the yellow tones, and then I'm giving some effects with burnt sienna and orange.
Thank you, Noreen. I'm glad you enjoy the classes. So it is a daffodil. I think somebody has already answered the question. The yellow flower is a daffodil flower.
Just adding some darker streaks with burnt sienna and orange.
If anyone has any questions, feel free to answer. Feel free to ask in the comment section. We will try to answer as many as possible. And we are continuing with painting the flower.
So I am done with the center. I'm going to move on to the leaves which are on the outer side. So I'm going to do this shadowy part which is there on the lower side of the of this center over here. And I'm going to use orange and burnt sienna and a little bit of yellow.
Prerna, this is a class to learn knife painting. So I do not understand your question. So if you wish to learn, then you should follow and try to do it.
I'm going to start doing the shadowy portion from here. Make sure that you do a dark tone near the petals that we have previously painted. By dark, I mean you mix burnt sienna and orange. As you come out onto the lower side, you can add a lot of orange with the burnt sienna.
Ovita, how much paint should be put on the flower? Is it a thick layer or a thin layer?
Thick layer
of paint.
Thick layer.
So usually knife painting has little bit of a texture, so you should use a little thick layer. But then ultimately how much thickness you keep is totally your choice. If you want to keep it keep the texture very prominent, then you will use a very thick layer. If you want it subtle, then you will use a slightly thinner layer of paint. But the point of doing knife painting is to have a texture or a thick stroke. So there should be a certain little thickness to the paint so that you can see your strokes properly. And yes, tube colors is correct. We are using tube colors. And currently on the palette, white, lemon yellow, orange, burnt sienna, which is a lighter brown, and burnt umber, which is a darker brown, are on my palette right now. Different brands have different names to their colors, so in general, it's a light yellow, an orange, a light brown, a dark brown, and white. the quantity of paint, as you can see while we are working, is very less on the knife, depends on where you are applying it. I have limited screen space, so I cannot keep the palette inside the video. Prerna, that's what we are already showing and demonstrating. That's how you do the knife painting. So it's already being demonstrated in the video.
Go on till about here.
You will use the back of the knife and pick it up with the back of the knife, which is how you apply it. Carefully observe the video. You will get a clearer idea of what to do.
I am applying a little bit of yellow over here to get little lesser dark tone.
Good morning. Showing the colors that are being used, I've already mentioned all of them, and I have limited screen space, so I cannot keep the palette inside the video. I have already mentioned this here, and I have mentioned the colors. They are mentioned in the poster, which has already been released as well, and it's mentioned during the class also multiple times. I have white, I have a light yellow, I have light brown and dark brown, and an orange shade on the palette. Good morning, Syed Mumtaz.
Alright, we are done with this part, the shadowy part of the flower. Now, I'm going to do this particular petal. So, I'm taking a lot of yellow and a little orange and going to give strokes like that. From here where we left.
Good morning, Azu.
Make sure that you don't make it too dark, because we have already done the shadowy area and this has to show. This is another little bit of a shadowy part of the petal, hence it has some orangish tones in it. Use lemon yellow and orange both.
Morning to everybody who has just joined. Welcome to our Facebook, free Facebook live every Friday at 11 a.m. Today's topic is knife painting, and that's what we are doing today. We are painting this very pretty yellow daffodil flower today. It's a fairly simple composition. All class details have been already released at least three, four days before the class, so that you can keep it ready if you wish to work with us through the session.
So we're done with this one. Now I'm just cleaning my knife completely. I'm going to work on this petal, which is lighter yellow.
Yes, Apurva, whenever you switch from one color to another, especially to a lighter shade, you should clean your knife, because otherwise you will end up losing your light shade and it will all become dark. Not so much true the other way around, because the darker shade will not be as much affected, but in general you should make it a habit to keep your tools clean or keep cleaning them regularly, so that you don't end up with the wrong shades when you are applying it.
adding a tiny bit of white over here with the lemon yellow. In this corner, and then finishing the petal with yellow. We are not looking for very uniformity in our strokes. Knife painting is about very rugged looking strokes.
Kanji, acrylic paints dry pretty quickly, so if your weather is not very moist or humid, then it will dry within an hour or even sooner than that, depending on how thick your layer is.
Doing this small area, which is also a little bit in the shadow, so mixing a little bit of orange and with the lemon yellow.
Okay, Meenu, we'll try to speak up.
Just adding a little darkish tone there. I'm mixing orange and burnt sienna. Over here, this is the shadowy part of the flower. So just adding some dark tone over here. This is just finishing with the shapes. Now I'm just cleaning my knife completely. I'm going to work with lemon yellow now. So just putting the yellow here. There is one small yellow portion here as well. Going with the shape all the way till the edge. Adding a little white here. Then working with yellows over here. Adding a little bit of orangish tone there. And then whites over here. So whenever you are applying white from top, and if you have a shade on the lower side, then don't press your knife, just apply it from top. Otherwise it just mixes around with the shade which is on the lower side, and then you just get a very even looking tone, which we don't want. Now I'm just going to add a few darkish effects over here at the base to get some contrast here, so that this petal is kind of distinguished from the other. Now I'm going to move on to this one, which is fairly light. So I'm taking lots of yellow. Thank you. cleaning my knife completely. Keeping it here, going around from here outside, from here that way. Knife should move that way, the way the petal is. Just adding a tinge of orange just to get some little darkish tone. Also just darkening this part a little. So that the petal that we are painting right now is very clearly visible. Painting is all about contrast colors. Close to each other. Just added a tiny bit of orange there. In the lemon yellow. So make sure that both the shades are there in your on your knife, and then you just don't use only one shade, otherwise it'll kind of stand out. Now I'm going to add some white tones, white effects on the petal. Now when I'm adding the whites, I'm not kind of brushing my knife onto the surface. I'm just applying the white. If I press my knife on the surface, then it's just going to mix with the base shade and will become white, monotone.
Joined the class. This is a Facebook live free workshop to learn knife painting with us.
Just mixing some white with the yellow. Wherever there is no space to move the knife, just use the tip of the knife. Adding a tinge of orange with lemon yellow here. Lot of white over here.
Kritika, all the petals have a little bit of white. Observe the original reference that we have picked and see where the white tones are in that. The white is being applied according to that.
Applying a little orange and burnt sienna on this one on the tip.
Do you recommend to completely cover the lines of the pencil? Yes, Angie. Because the sketch is for our reference to be able to know where to paint. But we don't need the outlines in your finished piece. So with the paint, you should cover up your outlines so that they are not visible later in the composition. So yes, you should cover up the sketch lines.
A few darkish effects over here on this particular petal. So just taking the orange and burnt sienna, cleaning my knife, and then I'm going to just merge it with the lemon yellow. The upper side has a lot of light on the petal, so it has a lot of yellow tone. So just applied the yellow. Make sure that you merge it well. There is a little darkish tone over here on the edge. So just applied a little bit of orange and burnt sienna with the yellow. This has to be yellow because the center over here is dark. So make sure that you do a this section has to be a little dark towards the center here. This one. Adding some contrast tones there. Then with the knife, just putting some strokes there so that it looks nice. Cleaning my knife, just filling the gap which is here. Just a few strokes of white there. So if you are putting white from top, just gently touch the knife to the surface. Do not drag it. That way. And just before we move on to the other petal, so I just need to give a little bit of darkish stroke over there so that these two are distinguished from each other. So I just added a little bit of burnt sienna there to get some darkish looking tone there. So it goes like this. and then just that should be good. Now I'm going to do this particular petal. I'm first taking a lot of yellow. We are going to add a little bit of white in this one. As I move up, adding a little bit of orange. Moving here, adding a lot of burnt sienna and orange with the lemon yellow. This corner should have a little bit of darkish tone. Make sure it's not darker than the one which we have done in the core.
Is it okay to do with bottle acrylic, Rashmi Rekha? No, you have to use tube colors because we need a thicker consistency. Bottle colors are more dilute and have a loose consistency, which is not suitable for application with a palette knife. So you need a thicker consistency. So you need to use tube colors.
Adding a little bit of orange over here with the lemon yellow. And then there is a lot of mixed tone in between here, which is actually lot of white. So I'm just putting white there first, and then I'll add a little bit of tone in it. So just adding a few touches of burnt sienna, but I like to leave it white basically.
Charul Sarin, that is not true. Always depends on your skill. Acrylics give the same effect as oil colors if you know how to use them. So that's not true. Best work is in the hands of the artist, not the medium.
So I am done with the flower. Now we're going to do the leaves.
Prerna, that is why you have a reference picture. So you look at the reference picture and you decide what kind of strokes you require to get the effect. Whether you want it flat or you want it 3D, that is decided from the picture that you have picked as a reference, and where you want the 3D structure to be visible and where you want the paint to be a little more flat. And Sharul, yes, that is true. Everybody's choices are different, so, and comfort is also different. So some people prefer working with oils, some people prefer working with acrylics. It depends on your personal skill and choice.
So now we are going to paint the leaves, and I have taken sap green. I want you to take a little sap green, some white, and a little bit of olive green. If you don't have olive green, even sap green works.
Olive green is basically a darker shade of green. So wherever you see a dark green stroke, you will apply a little darker green. If you don't have olive green, you can use a dark brown or black with the sap green or your lighter green.
There is not much space to move your knife, so I will suggest that you just keep your knife vertical and use it like a pencil.
Charul, I'm not sure about that. I think chalk paints beyond a certain consistency cannot be thickened. They don't have the texture or the body that is required in paints to do 3D effects. So I'm not sure about that. Also, if it's too thick, I think it will become a little grainy. But would love to try. I haven't given that a try yet.
Still, wherever the petals, wherever the leaves are a little narrow, I'm only using the tip of the knife to give the shape.
And thank you, Tanuja, and thank you, Nitika. I'm glad that everybody is still here. Morning and welcome to everybody who may have joined a little later. My name is Akanksha and my partner's name is Seema. We are a mother-daughter duo who run our Canvas Design Studio together. And Seema ji is taking today's class.
Just adding a little white on the lower side of the leaf. Still working with only the tip of the knife because there's not much space to move the knife. Adding a little white on the lower part of the there. It's perfectly fine even if you just use the knife that way, like a pencil. There is a little whitish tone on the entire lower part of the leaf. So I'm just applying that, and then I will apply the darker area, which is on the upper side. Now I'm going to use sap green, and I've taken it on the edge of the knife.
Thank you, Charul. And Angie, I'm glad. You're most welcome. I'm glad everybody is enjoying the class. It is a nice composition. I think we are also enjoying painting it.
Be careful near the petal.
Thank you, Tanuja.
Trying to merge the white with the green.
So in general, for all the leaves, for Shagun, the left edge is a little darker, so that will have a little bit of the olive green, and the right side is a little lighter, so it will have white and sap green. So white is with the sap green. And olive green is applied only on the left side after you have done the base color. to give a little more contrast on the left side of the leaves. And that is the same color flow that we'll do for all the leaves. Thank you, Mridula.
Moving on to this one. Now taking the sap green on this side.
Bucky Sophia, you can reach us on the chat. If you wish to buy anything, you can let me know on Instagram chat or Facebook chat, or you can WhatsApp us and I will let you know the price. So Sharul, acrylics already have a resin pigment in them to give it a gloss finish, so I usually do not recommend using anything on top, but we don't varnish the pieces as well because it's not really required, but you can use if you want a further gloss to your piece or a matte finish to your piece, then you can use varnish. There are many types available in the market, so you can pick the finish you want and use that. Yes, correct. That's precisely why we don't use varnish, because we have been painting for a long time and initially we used to use it, but we also felt that over time it kind of yellows and it spoils the shades of the canvas also. Initially it looks very nice, but later on the painting loses its original color. So I don't usually recommend it, and acrylics, like I said, already have a resin pigment in them, so they already have a kind of a coating, and it dries with a little little plasticky or little glossy kind of a texture, like a feel already. So ideally it doesn't really require any varnish, but personal choice, and a lot of people look at other people and do it, so I don't have any comments about it, but you can. Yeah, it is very hard, that is correct. I like the colors the way they look. I don't like to coat it with anything. Like to see the paints as they are.
This one is a little brown, so we'll finish all the greens first.
Stem of the flower.
Yeah.
Can finish the leaves and then do the
brown
stem.
using olive green on the extreme left. When you want a clean edge on anything, use the side of the knife. Take paint on the edge of the knife and just go that way. About that. We just left with the last one, which is here. I'm just putting sap green and white on the right side of this leaf. I'm taking both sap green and white, both that way. It's a wide leaf, so we have a lot of space to move the entire knife. The left side, I'm putting a lot of olive green, just kind of merging it with this. The beauty of knife painting is about not being uniform, so we are not looking for a uniform looking surface. Now I'm cleaning my knife completely. I'm going to do the stem, and I'm going to use white and burnt sienna for the stem. So just cleaning my knife and taking some burnt sienna and white. Thank you, Charul. So my knife is clean now, and I'm going to take white first. Why we take white first is that we want to kind of not lose the white while we are doing other effects, and finally we want the white to merge on whatever tones we are doing. So that's why I put the white first. Then now I'm going to take burnt sienna on the edge of the knife. Keep it there. Right, make a straight edge the way we want. Right, go till the flower. Use a little orange on the lower side with the burnt sienna. This white which is there, it's going to show once we do the background. Right now it may not show so much, but it will show once we do the background. Fix the angle of the stem properly. It's almost close to the green stem. Go right till the petal. Finish the proper shape of this. So we have the stem there. We are done with the entire flower and the stems. Now we are going to start doing the background. For the background, we will require a lot of white. It's going to be a little lighter on top, and a little bit of yellow ochre I'm taking. I'm going to take a broad brush. It is a flat number 5. Do not make it too dark. We're not looking for a dark background because it's going to overshadow the flower otherwise. So I've taken yellow ochre. Basically controlling the tone with the help of white.
Charul, thank you.
Little bit of yellow ochre as you go closer to the petals. Closer to the petals, more of ochre. Away from the petals, lot of white.
Sorry about that little brief interruption. Can anybody confirm if the video is still on and you can hear us, right?
Again, we are not looking for a very uniform background because that goes with our knife painting. So I'm going to do patches of yellow, ochre and white.
You can see us and you can hear us, right? Just confirming. Great. Thank you.
This is the time when you can hide all your sketch marks. Thanks, Nitika. Now as we move here, I'm going to start adding a little bit of burnt sienna over here and white. Okay, little change of tone here, but still controlling the whole thing with white. We don't want very darkish looking tones here. As we come down, going to use a little orange over here with white. Generally, as you go down, you must use a little darkish tone. So over here, I'm using burnt sienna white. Over here as well. Always gives a little depth to your picture if you add little bit of darkish tones on the lower side.
Prerna, to solve your palette problem, you should check the YouTube video which is posted. It will be in a horizontal format, so if the palette is visible in will be visible in that video. I cannot include it in the screen on this live because I have limited screen space. But the YouTube video will have the entire table visible, so maybe that will help you with your palette visibility issue.
There is a little small orange portion there. Orange and white over here. Part of the background. Back to the broad brush. Use a lot of burnt sienna just next to the white that we have put on the stem. You'll be able to see the white of the stem.
Thank you, Kiran. We are almost done, just working on the background. Little yellowish tones in this corner now, which is left. And then we will be done. If anyone has any questions, you are welcome to ask in the comments. If you are looking for the reference and the sketch and the material details, they have been posted to our Facebook and Instagram pages. This live will be posted for a few weeks on our Facebook page, and the entire recording of today's live will be posted to our YouTube channel. Our name is Art Canvas Design Studio across all social media handles. So you can just type in the search bar and you will find us. The previous lives have also been shared on YouTube. In case this is your first one and you wish to paint more with us, then you can have a look at the old class recordings as well and do those.
Little yellowish orange tone here, just to go in with the shades of the flower, and then on the lower side a little darkish as usual. Like I mentioned, little darker always on the lower side looks nicer in pictures. It adds depth to it. Yeah, Prerna, thanks for following on all platforms. It is great to know. Lots of yellow over here.
Our WhatsApp number is also available on all the channels, or I will put it in the comment section later where you can reach us. Everybody enjoyed today's session. Nice bright yellow flower in knife, with knife today. Do let us know in the comments if you have any feedback to share with us. If you enjoyed the class, keeps us motivated to try and keep new things every week. If you want us to teach anything else, you can let us know. If you wish to join any other workshops that are paid sessions through the month, which are many, almost every day, then you can feel free to join those as well. And we are done with today's class. I hope everybody enjoyed the session, and we hope to see you all next week on Friday. The class has already been announced for next Friday, but the image and sketch will be released shortly. I believe it's a mud mirror workshop next Friday, which was requested earlier by a few of you, so we have decided to take that up. So we shall take your leave now. Hope everybody enjoyed the class, and have a good weekend, and see you all next Friday.